go to the tools panel of Affinity Photo or Designer or Publisher and create a design like this using any of the tools. Modify it in a number of ways. And once you've done that, you can save this design as a preset in any of the applications. And you can go up here, there's a little gear or settings, and click there and you'll see all the current existing ones. You can also go to the right side menu and click there and create presets. So I'm just going to create this one. Just going to say, call it gear 22, something like that, whatever. Click create and it's just saved there as gear 22. Now that's a user preset. You'll notice here you've got some affinity ones. Now these ones are separate. These are part of the application. These ones, however, are used ones. You get a little sort of label there associated with that. But what you can also do is you can go to this menu again and you notice another option, manage presets. Well, manage presets, and this is in Photo, I could be in Designer, doesn't matter. Well, what I can do, go down here, export user presets. So any of my user presets, I can export. If I go down this list, it's quite a long display now, takes a bit of time to display it, but I can say export user presets. And I'm just going to save it to a file, and it's doesn't matter what you call it, but it's an AF tool presets file. And then you can say export. Obviously, I'm going to replace that one. So it's replaced. And I've got this file now. What I can do, I can go to Designer. So let's just go to Designer. So Affinity Designer. And I can say import presets. This is exactly the same. So if I go up here, I've got this design, click there, right side, manage presets. Exactly the same as before. And I can say import presets. So I can click there, select that file, import. Now it doesn't give you any message. It doesn't say it's like, 500 have been saved or anything. But if you go down the bottom, you can now see gear 22 has been saved to this. So you can now use it. So if I go to the, what's the name? Let's just go for the various tools and I'm just gonna go for the cog tool. I always call it gear. I don't know why, but that's what, and you can just use that. But also what you got now with the presets is you can click there and you can see as you go down here, you can just select that one and there is your design from Photo. Go to Publisher. In Publisher, what you can do exactly the same. We've got all the various tools here and I'm gonna go for the cog tool and you can see a cog already there. What I can now do is just go up here, again to the little settings here. Takes a few seconds to come up and of course it's not added yet because I haven't done right side there. Manage presets, click there, takes a few seconds to come up. And now what I can do, I can import presets. Click there and again, select that file, import and close. Doesn't tell you, which would be nice if it did actually. But however, what you can do now with that, click there and I can, once it gets in there, you can see there it is. Quickly added to Publisher as well as Designer. And you can do the same. If you're in Designer, you can create stuff, save it as a file, that AF tool presets file, and then bring it into Publisher, etc. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.